Hi everyone. In this video, let us discuss when to avoid the use of Phentermine. So what are the important contraindications of this drug? We will discuss in this video. What is this drug Phentermine? Phentermine is classified as anorectic agent. So this drug is a sympathomimetic and it is structurally related with the amphetamine. Being a sympathomimetic, it acts centrally to reduce the intake of the food, thereby it reduces the appetite. That's why Phentermine can be used for the short-term treatment of exogenous obesity. So in those patients with body mass index greater than or equal to 30 kg per square meter who are classified as obese, this Phentermine can be used to reduce the body weight for a short-term period. And generally, this drug can be combined with another drug, topiramate, which is an anti-epileptic agent. So along with proper diet control and exercise, Phentermine can be used as weight loss medication. This drug can also be given in few of the patients with body mass index greater than or equal to 27 kg per square meter who are associated with few of the risk factors that increase cardiovascular complications. So in the patients with controlled hypertension, diabetes or elevated levels of lipids, the BMI should be controlled less than 27 kg per square meter. In such conditions, Phentermine can be used for short-term period to reduce the body weight. Even this drug is used for short-term period in the management of obesity, but it is not suitable in all types of patients. In few of the patients, this drug can be given, but in few of the patients, this drug is contraindicated. So let us see what are the conditions where this Phentermine should be avoided. First one is the use of MAO inhibitors. In few of the patients, MAO inhibitors like phenylgine, tranylcypromine, isocarboxide, these type of drugs can be used to control the depression, and these are the non-selective MAO inhibitors. Another drug is the selegiline, which is a MAO B inhibitor used for the treatment of Parkinson's disease. If any of these drugs are combined with Phentermine, this combination may increase the hypertension, resulting in the elevated blood pressure. And within few days, this combination may result in severe hypertension leading to hypertensive crisis. This is a fatal condition which requires emergency treatment. That's why MAO inhibitor should not be combined with the Phentermine. So Phentermine should be avoided in those patients who are taking the MAO inhibitors. And if it is required, 14 days gap should be maintained between the use of MAO inhibitors and Phentermine in order to avoid any development of hypertensive crisis in the patients. So before use of Phentermine, the patient history should be studied, and in case of any administration of MAO inhibitors within 14 days, the therapy with Phentermine should not be initiated. Second condition is the hyperthyroidism. Just we have seen that Phentermine is a sympathomimetic. This drug is going to block one of the transporter N18. Norepinephrine transporter on the presynaptic nerve terminals within the hypothalamus. This results in the increased sympathetic activation within the CNS, leading to increased release of norepinephrine, which may produce various effects on systemic organs. And the raised levels of norepinephrine can also affect the thyroid gland, resulting in hyperthyroidism. So Phentermine can increase the risk of hyperthyroidism. If already patient is having the hyperthyroidism, in such conditions, Phentermine should not be used. So this drug is strictly contraindicated in the patients with hyperthyroidism. In the susceptible patients, thyroid function should be done before initiation of the therapy in order to avoid the development of hyperthyroidism and associated symptoms. Third condition is the agitated states. In few of the patients, we can observe excessive anxiety, severe agitation, irritability, restlessness. If any of these conditions are excessively observed in the patients, then again Phentermine is contraindicated because this drug can increase the central sympathetic discharge, thereby it can centrally increase the anxiety, agitation, insomnia. So in the patients with any previous history of agitated states, this drug is contraindicated. Fourth one is the glaucoma. Normally, with the use of Phentermine, we can observe few of the adverse effects on the eye. With increased use of this drug, acute angle closure can be observed in the patients, and this drug may also decrease the vision. And particularly when this drug is combined with other drugs like topiramate, It can increase the suprachoroidal effusions and even it can develop myopia, nearsightedness. All these effects can be observed with the phentermine, particularly when it is combined with other drug like topiramate. If patient is already having a history of glaucoma, we can observe a raised intraocular pressure. In such conditions, phentermine can further increase the IOP, thereby it can increase the risk of severe glaucoma. That's why in the patient, phentermine is contraindicated. Fifth one is a pregnancy. In the pregnant woman, we can observe so many types of maternal changes. One of the changes is the increase in the body weight, which is essential. But if the woman is already obese before the pregnancy, the increase in the body weight may lead to few of the systemic complications. Still, in such conditions, phentermine should not be used because phentermine can produce some teratogenic effects. So, in the pregnant woman, this drug is strictly contraindicated. Sixth one is the nursing woman. In the breastfeeding woman, again, phentermine is contraindicated because phentermine is one of the sympathomimetic and it is structurally related with the amphetamine. So, phentermine is an amphetamine derivative. Generally, amphetamines are secreted into the milk. Thereby, they increase the consumption of this drug by infants. So, when this drug is consumed by infant, it may lead to central as well as cardiac stimulation, resulting in development of convulsions, tachycardia, palpitations, which are fatal. That's why, again, in the nursing woman, this phentermine is contraindicated. Seventh one is uncontrolled hypertension. We have seen that phentermine can be given in the patients with controlled hypertension, where the blood pressure is under control, either by exercise, diet, or medication. But in those patients with uncontrolled hypertension, again this phentermine is contraindicated. Since this drug increases the norepinephrine levels, it can increase the blood pressure, resulting in hypertension. And this drug can also increase primary pulmonary hypertension, PPH, where the blood pressure is increased in the pulmonary blood vessels, which is a fatal condition resulting in dyspnea, difficulty in breathing, and edema. Because of these effects with the phentermine, in the patients with uncontrolled hypertension, this drug is contraindicated. Eighth one is a cardiovascular disorders. In the patients with any cardiac arrhythmias or congestive heart failure, any recent history of stroke, in such patients, phentermine is strictly contraindicated because this drug may produce one of the condition valvulopathy. It can produce inflammation of the coronary walls, particularly the mitral wall and tricuspid walls are damaged with long-term use of phentermine. That's why phentermine is indicated only for short-term therapy. But in the patients with previous history of cardiovascular complications like arrhythmia, congestive heart failure or stroke, this drug may further impair the cardiac functionality by damaging the cardiac walls as well as increasing the blood pressure. That's why in the patients with any cardiovascular disorders, again, phentermine is contraindicated. Ninth one is the hypersensitivity. Just like the amphetamine, phentermine can also produce some hypersensitive reactions resulting in angioedema, swelling of lips, throat, neck, and pharynx, which may result in the difficulty in swallowing, and it can also produce some skin rashes. If these symptoms are developed, they may produce fatal systemic effects. So in such conditions, again, phentermine is contraindicated. So these are the various conditions where use of phentermine is not preferred and it is strictly contraindicated. The first one is the use of phentermine along with MAO inhibitors is contraindicated because of development of hypertensive crisis. So a 14 days gap should be maintained between the use of MAO inhibitors and use of phentermine. And this drug is also contraindicated in the pregnant woman and nursing woman. In the conditions like glaucoma and hyperthyroidism, again this drug is contraindicated. In those patients with any previous history of cardiovascular disorders, uncontrolled hypertension, or in case of development of hypersensitive reactions, in all such conditions, phentermine is strictly contraindicated. Apart from these conditions, in other patients with obesity, phentermine can be used for short-term period to reduce the body weight. But this drug may increase the blood pressure, anxiety and insomnia as important side effects. So that's all about the contraindications of phentermine. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.